Hey creative people, how are you? Welcome to the second day of Inktober 2020, and today's prompt is WISP. If you have got no idea what a WISP is, let me give you just one example. Have you seen the Brave movie? Remember those smoky little blue ghosts that Merida used to follow around on the jungle? Well, those are just one example of WISP, and this has other meanings also. But I'm not going to talk about them in this video today, because I got inspired from the WISPs of Brave movie for this drawing. And you obviously can Google the other meanings up if you are interested. So let's talk about the inking now. As usual of the Inktober, I am still using my favorite acrylic inks, and I'm using two colors right now, and they are Primary Cyan and Phthalo Turquoise. And the surface I'm using is a watercolor papered notebook. I mean sketchbook. I'm now taking off some of the inks from the white areas, and now I'm going to use some super opaque white ink to give the highlights and to make some white areas more white. I'm using watercolor brushes here. Works really great. Okay, tell me, does it look like a wisp already or not? Besides my acrylic inks, I'm going to use some Chinese ink for the black colors. I've just made a mistake here and fixing it with the white ink. Again, drawing in some highlights and more white areas. I wanna say one thing, and that is I'm really grateful that I made up to the second day of Inktober, and I hope that I will go further than this. Right now I'm softening some hard edged white areas with some water, and I have to do this thing quickly after I apply the white areas, because I told you on the previous video that these inks dry up so fast. And yeah, if you like this video, then there's a chance that you would like the previous video more. So please, after you finish watching this, please go and see my first video of Inktober 2020. That was really my favorite drawing in a while. I'm already feeling satisfied with this little blue ghost here. Just some more highlights and some more blendings. And now darkening the eye areas a bit. Isn't this a cute little ghost? Darkening the areas around him a bit more. Some more whites and highlights. Now applying a black background. I don't know, I just feel I should do a black background. I don't know why, but I love black. And also, black kind of goes well with Inktober, the Inktober vibe. Well, this part always takes a bit more patience. Sometimes a lot of patience. But you know, you have to have patience when you are doing something creative. This looks good in the black background. I like it. You know, I still have no idea where this drawing is going and what am I going to do next. Just experimenting with it, just playing and having fun. Let's try and give this black a round kind of shape. Or what about drawing a tree beside it? One creepy little tree, because it's supposed to look a little bit creepy at least. And I really love drawing trees with these long trunks and branches. Trees are my favorite subject to draw since childhood. And a lot of them are leafless. Now we can give it a round shape. Some dry brush strokes around the edges. A little bit more rounding up. How about giving the background some colors? This sounds great. I have colorful inks, why don't I use them? Honestly speaking, yet I don't know where this is going. But it's going somewhere. And hopefully that somewhere isn't going to be so bad. Hey, I'm also curious how it looks like when I'm finished, so please bear with me. Right now I'm trying to mix some brown colors with the black ink, the naphthol red dip and the pyrrole orange. Using the deep colored ink on one side. Oh, another thing, this is not a realistic drawing or painting, so I'm not following any particular rules here. I'm just following my mind. And this feels so good. I have added some yellow splatters of inks to create some fireflies like things. In the end, but somehow I failed to capture that in the video. I'm so sorry about that. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you are joining Inktober also, then please share your artworks with me in the comment section. And if you have any ideas and if you got some suggestions for me to improve my artworks, then please feel free to share. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please give it a try. I will definitely appreciate that. So thanks again so much for watching, and I hope you stay safe, stay healthy and keep creating. Stay connected to Shuta's universe. And please keep watching till the end, because I have made some corrections there and I'm not finished yet.